I'm going to FOIA the best scores.
Yeah. this, where you, on the left-hand side, you've got those folders we were talking about, council, and photos of public. Mm-hmm. Okay, so if you touch the council folder, it should go ahead and scroll and let you see the files that are in that folder. Should be two of them. One of them's got today's date with the agenda packet, and the other is this guide that I was talking to you about earlier. And it's a pretty thick one, but the agenda packet is it's the full hard copy that you have in electronic format there. And really, at this point, all you have to do is touch that agenda icon, and it should take a few seconds, and it's there local on your iPad. And then, of course, we're going to go into the iAnnotate application to read it and mark it up and those kinds of things. That's really all you have to do with Dropbox.
Make it easier for older eyes.
Justin? You can make it hard.
All you got to do is with your fingers, like, just squeeze it or.
Yeah, let me show you that. And in fact, you may want to orient yours in a portrait format.
Yeah.
Okay. And real basically, there, if you look up on the screen, you'll see my fingers, and you have this pinching motion. If you expand your fingers, it zooms right down to the document, and then you can use your single finger.
It's instant.
It's instant.
I'm an immediate gratification person. Excuse me. Do that, Grant, and do it now.
And you can use your finger to go up and down, hand the document to the significant place else you want to look. And when we get into the actual PDF application, we'll do a lot more. But really the basics are moving the document around with the finger and then expanding it or shrinking it by just doing that pinching motion.
You can also, if you want to jump to the end of the document, you can grab a little bar.
And with it, again, iAnnotate, you can search on terms and jump right to that place in your documents.
Yeah, you can bookmark different parts of the agenda if you want to jump right.
Excellent tools. Okay.
Is the star of the bookmark tool?
You got to move it to iAnnotate.
Okay.
Yes.
Before we
leave this Dropbox application, a couple of other little just facts that are really good to know about. One, there is a way to delete documents from here. And you need to know that if you delete it from Dropbox, you really delete it from that Dropbox service and nobody else can have access. So don't be deleting documents. We'll do that for you. But I will show you how to delete documents from the iPad, because you now downloaded it from the Dropbox service to the local iPads. And you know, when you're done with documents, that's a good thing to know. But just a caution, don't worry.
Yes. I mean, does it have a certain amount that it will hold, and then you just need to delete some things?
Yeah, and depending on the size of the agendas, yes. You might keep 6 months worth of agendas out there, or a year's worth. Just kind of depends on how you want to use the storage space.
Mark it and make a folder for it?
Yes.
You can, I mean.
Yes.
Okay.
I think the point is, Dropbox for y'all is simply a delivery device to get the agenda into your iPad.
Right.
So you should really use it as a mailbox. You should pick it up and take it from out there. You shouldn't delete anything out there. If you delete it, it deletes it on my iPad and everybody else's iPad too. So, well, once it's in iAnnotate, so just use that as a place to grab the document and put it into your iPad in iAnnotate or whatever else you're reading it with. And then you can do what you want with it there. And also, you don't need to save this stuff forever in your iPad, because you can use the web browser and go right to the city's website looking at all the agendas for the last 10 years,
okay,
if you ever want to do that. So you just don't, unless you've got your own annotations on there that you want to save, then you can save it.
So once we open it in iAnnotate, if we open it again from iAnnotate, that's resident on ours.
Yeah,
that's right.
Once it's on iAnnotate, it's yours.
Okay. But the Dropbox stays the Dropbox.
Dropbox stays.
if you upload to, you can also do that with the iPad. If you upload a document, everybody gets it. And that can be a useful thing, but just be aware it is something that everybody has access to once you put it up there. Okay, so you synchronize your iPad with the documents that came from Dropbox. Now hit the button over to the, you've got it in the landscape menu. They call this the home button. So if you press that and you go back to the mobile screen, find that iPad.
Hold on just a minute, Jerry. We were at the Dropbox, and we were at today's agenda, which just popped up. Mm-hmm. Okay, how about if I get halfway through it, I want to stop right there, and I mean, it went right back to where I was. How can I say this is where I'm going to come back and take up again?
She's got to tell her I'm moving.
Yes.
Oh, it still has to go to I and the tape, which I have to know.
Well, open it from Dropbox.
Yes.
Okay. And then, rather than closing an app, look at the upper right-hand corner of Dropbox.
Yes.
There's a little arrow, a little square.
Yes.
You just touch that little icon, and it'll say open in something.
And then,
iron tail is now in those options.
And then you'll be able to work.
Document from within Dropbox, or do we need to go back there?
You probably should have picked it was a 1-2 down there, but I'm there with
you. Okay.
Okay.
So I'm moving
the cap,
I'm so sorry.
That's okay. No, this is your time. Make sure we're using
Dropbox. Right?
Wherever I'm supposed to be. Diana takes 3 days now.
Whoops. I don't have a problem.
Okay.
So you
got Diana.
Do we need to go back to Dropbox one more time? Because that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Where's everybody got the today's agenda on an iron table on the screen?
You got it.
Okay, we're good. Before we do anything in this application, let me just explain the screen a little bit. Up here in the upper left-hand corner, there's 4 icons, or little symbols. The very first one, it looks like a little filing cabinet, and we'll jump into that in a minute, but I just want to kind of tell you what these icons do for you. This is how you manage documents with this application. We'll get into that in just a minute, but again, just to kind of orient you. The one beside it with the down arrow, this is what allows you to download other documents from Dropbox. So there's a couple of different ways to do it. And as you